You know, I'm always fascinated sometimes by the idea that because we may have been involved in something before we were Christian, that once we become saved, that somehow we are able to look back on our previous life as though we were some kind of expert in that field, and that we would be given by God the wisdom to be able to know how to relate to and share with those that need the gospel. And I sadly have watched a very popular person fall from grace, that rather than turning his attention and focus on Jesus and the gospel, which we are told that if we lift him up, he would draw all men to himself, has focused on defending himself and to bitterly come back against those whom Jesus died for. And the reality is we're not here to defend ourselves. We're here to die. We're here to deny ourselves, to take up our cross and follow Jesus. And if that means that the crowds spit on you at times, guess what? The crowds will do as crowds do. Sometimes they will cheer you, and sometimes they will jeer you. Sometimes the best thing to do is to do nothing at all, and God will be your defense. At other times, point to Jesus. He is the reason we're here. He is our salvation. Always remember that. He is our salvation in every situation. They are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. In the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Such an high priest became us, who is holy, harmless, undefiled, separate from sinners, that you may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God, without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation. Jesus of Nazareth went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. As we have therefore opportunity, let us do good unto all men, especially unto them that are of the household of faith. That was the true light which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. You are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. In recognizing circumstances and situations that God tells us ahead of time that we're going to be put in, we need to prepare ourselves for a response so that we would be acknowledging that we are no greater and no lesser and no worse off than the sinner that is not saved, because we've been saved by grace. And if grace has been given us, then grace we must extend not only to those who are fallen in the faith, but those who are without the faith, that we would be blameless before God, that we would not accuse or recuse those who do not know Jesus yet. I see so often people attack other religions or attack each other. God never made us a pack of dogs. He made us to be the light of the world. He didn't create us to be wolves tearing at one another or at prey, but rather he called us to save a godless, perverse nation. And not by changing the nation, but by saving the soul. What's your purpose? And what are you doing? Are you an activist? Or are you actively involved in Jesus? He that is of a merry heart hath a continual feast. The joy of the Lord is your strength. The kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. Be filled with the Spirit, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. By him let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually, that is, the fruit of our lips giving thanks to his name. although the fig tree shall not blossom, neither shall fruit be in the vines, the labor of the olive shall fail, and the field shall yield no meat. The flocks shall be cut off from the field, and there shall be no herd in the stalls. Yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. Sorrowful, yet always rejoicing, we glory in tribulations also. Jesus said it. Jesus meant it. Jesus told us, in the world you shall have tribulations. But he said that in me you shall have peace. If we are in Jesus, we can have peace in the midst of our tribulations. And literally, although it may seem strange to you at the time that you're going through it, you can rejoice in the Lord. It is a, not only a possibility, but a probability as you grow in the knowledge of him, that you will rejoice and be glad.